What is up, everyone? What is going on? I am here in Ohio. I never thought I'd be in Ohio. First time in Ohio, and here with Ken Lewis, mixmaster extraordinaire, and home of Mix Night Audio. How are you doing, Ken?
I'm doing great. Thanks for having me.
Oh, dude, thank you for having me.
We're going to have the best show tonight. Yeah. It's going to be amazing.
That's right. And if this will be coming out after the show, if you guys want to see the actual mixing show, I'll link it down in the description.
Yes, mixing night. It's Atmos night tonight. We're doing all things Atmos.
Yeah, it's going to be fantastic. So make sure you watch the replay down below. And if you caught the live stream, hey, we thank you for being there. I'm not going to go through your list of credits because it would take an hour at least.
Here's the short list. I'm a Grammy winner. I'm credited on 114 gold records. I've worked with everybody from Taylor Swift, BTS, the old Kanye, Common, Drake, you name it. I've probably worked with them.
And Wu-Tang.
Wu-Tang, yeah.
I mixed when I saw that, I was just like, oh, I got I'm going to rap you my favorite Wu-Tang verse after this.
Nice.
Yes.
No,
love it. Now we are in Studio A. Here
we're
at your home.
In Atmos Studio A. We're fully immersive here. Atom 914 setup. We're wired for 916 and 360. We've currently got a 914 installed in this room and our B room. And we run Atmos in both rooms like crazy.
Yes, I've been in both rooms. I actually did a sprint mix in here yesterday. And that was actually pretty cool.
That's a lot of fun, right?
Yeah, yeah.
It gets your brain out of the tech and makes you focus on the music.
Right, right. So it's what a sprint mix is 10 minutes.
10 minutes faders down to finished. The best rough mix you can possibly do with 30 mixed stems from a finished mix. So if you're a nerd and understand that, then sprint mixing is for you.
Great. I have a few questions here. When did you start mixing Atmos?
About 3 years ago. Basically, as soon as I saw Apple announce spatial audio streaming, I was like, well, the biggest creative company in the entire world has adopted a streaming platform for the first time for Atmos. This is it. Time to adopt. My opinion on Atmos is all of us creatives in the music industry who are like making mixes and content and everything for Atmos, we're the cannon fodder. The only reason we exist is so that Apple can have their product lines and develop their new technology. We are only the people feeding the content into the system. And,
right. You guys are making the stuff,
right?
Essentially.
So every time somebody asks me, like, well, do you think Atmos is going to stay? You're thinking about yourself, not Apple and Dolby and the way they think. They're like, this is going to stay.
This is the long haul.
Yeah. They're making long-term investments in this for long-term product lines that's going to keep Atmos around for a long time.
So as far as mixing Atmos, what would you say is your end goal per track? What are you trying to accomplish, convey?
When you're hired as a mixer, my job is to deliver an Atmos mix that doesn't mimic the stereo, but gives you the same emotional feel and impact as the stereo mix. It's not a diversion from, it's just meant to put you into the middle of the song instead of an observer listening to two speakers from a distance or on headphones. And it's always the way I've wanted to experience music, from the center of it, being immersed in it, and not as an observer. So
yeah, I like that.
That's more connected. And the first time you ever hear, the thing that really sold me was the first time I heard a great Atmos mix on speakers, I was like, what is this? It was the most incredible audio thing I had ever heard and absolutely needed to do that. Atmos is a headphone technology. It's going to be a headphone technology for a little while. Cars are adopting sound bars, home theaters. Guys like you are really pushing the technology, which we absolutely love. We need to clone you 1,000 times and get more content out there. Just from a love of the format is why I'm in it. Okay. And, the format needs work, but got people like us trying to make it as good as it can.
Hey, what are the challenges when you have to balance both the speaker array and the headphone?
Oh, that's the hardest thing. So the translation with Atmos as a mixer is a super challenge. You've got to make the headphone mix feel like a better version of the stereo. So the balances have to be similar, the feel and the energy has to be similar, and there are ways to do that. But then you have to make sure that mix energy is transferred to the speakers in the same way, because the way Atmos translates in headphones is not the way Atmos translates on speakers. So that can be a real challenge. You can get too creative and take the listener out of the experience. My goal is always to just put you into the middle of the song that you love and surround you with it and make it the most interesting experience of the song that you already love.
Yeah, nice. Yeah, I can imagine it's hard. And I've been going over deliverables, and you know, they have, you know, Dolby has this one file that, you know, it's like a, and it, you know, one size fits all, and it kind of doesn't. And it's one of the things that I think hopefully we can, you know, change. I've been saying on the channel plenty of times, like, you know, maybe we could just do a specific mix for a specific, you know, delivery. Like the AC4, I think they call it, for the Android phones is taking the Dolby renderer mix, the binaural for them, right? And then the Apple one, the AC3, is actually taking the 714 and then in the AirBuds themselves using Apple's Spatial to make that a thing.
It's all so confusing.
Yeah, it is. And I'm just getting confused reading it, right?
Yeah. And the problem is nobody wants to pay for this work. So you need the stereo, but you don't necessarily need the Atmos. It's an on-top thing. Mm-hmm. It's a... After the fact, it's, you know...
It's the cherry on top.
Right. So a lot of people just don't want to pay for it. And it's a labor-intensive work. So, well, it depends on what you do. Sometimes the Atmos mixes go much faster than the stereo. Sometimes the Atmos mixes... Like, I'm mixing Catalog right now. I'm mixing, I think it'll be out by the time this is out, Live Throwing Copper, which is about to have its 30th anniversary on April 26th, and the Immersive album I'm mixing here right now. It is the challenge of a lifetime, but I'm up for it.
I saw some of it yesterday. It's very, very, very challenging. It's very cool. I love that album. I listened to it a whole lot. I used to, in college when it came out. Like, we were so into that.
Me too. I mean, it was, to put that in perspective, it was such a huge influence on me musically. I was 24 when that came out, and I listened to that album hundreds of times, and it influenced the way I produce, it influenced the way I write, it influenced the way I mix and create in general. And to have the opportunity 30 years later to be responsible for delivering the Immersive mix of that is, you know, it's a big weight, but I like pressure, so.
Yeah, I mean, and it's a awesome full circle moment.
How the heck I got tapped to do this? Thank you very much, Universe. I appreciate that.
In 2014, that's when they started putting Atmos in the home, or that's when they kind of announced it and they started, you know, working towards that. And we're in 2024 now. 10 years. What are your thoughts as far as how much longer until we get maybe some wider adoption? What are your thoughts?
Man, I think the wider adoption is going to come with some sort of event happening. Like, concerts start regularly be held in Atmos, or, you know, the wide adoption of things like the Apple Vision Pro, things like that, which is not going to happen anytime soon. You know, this is a niche format for a while. It's just going to be, I don't know, maybe another 10 years, it'll be super adopted by everybody and it'll just be a normal part of daily life. But I think that's going to take a while. I think we're looking at an audio format, like an audiophile format, that's not really being treated like an audiophile format. And it's just going to take a while for everybody to learn the tech, get used to it, know what they're even listening to, and, you know.
Right, understand it.
Right. I think one of the biggest challenges right now is that even on your phone, sometimes your service, the Atmos mix, when you only want the stereo, and you have an Atmos mix coming out of two speakers on your iPhone, which sounds like shit. I don't know why Apple is like, your phone should show up with Atmos off. And if you want it, then you turn it on automatic and you get the Atmos fed to you. That should be the best way for the user experience.
Right.
That way you get the song that you know and love whenever you want it. And then if you want the HD version, you listen to the Atmos.
Right.
But that's not the way they're rolling it out.
And it's very hard to find the switch. I saw Nolan making a video, his assistant Nolan was making a video yesterday, and it's buried. Buried in the, and half the people don't even know what that swipe down for the control center is.
I feel like Dolby should have set up a TikTok in 2021 with hey, here's how you, you know,
informational TikTok off.
Because you can guarantee that our Atmos Mixing Night show, we're going to chop that into TikTok and Reels segments.
Yeah, sure,
and,
sure.
You know, I wish that Apple and Dolby were more proactive with training and teaching and educating the general public and the creatives. We get not very much support from them at all. So, out in the wild, wild west trying to learn this format and maximize it and make it as amazing as possible. And it's a challenge, but we're up for it.
Yeah, I can't wait for the show tonight. It's going to be awesome.
So my website is kenlewis.com. Everything about me is basically there. Tune into Mixing Night on YouTube. It's a free 2-hour live stream, first Wednesday of every month. And it's basically like a studio variety show. It's not like a, you know, it's not a static interview thing. There's a lot going on. So we got that going on. And upcoming releases, I have Tosh Farrant, brilliant blues guitarist, 14-year-old kid from Australia, just finished his fourth U.S. tour. Yeah, it was incredible. He pulled up the tour bus in November, and we got started on an album, and they're coming back in a couple weeks to finish it up. And just a next-level talent. So check out Tosh Farrant. Check out the Throwing Copper and Atmos when it comes out April 26th. Please. I mean, none of the mixes have been approved yet, so it may not. You just never know.
Might get pushed back a little bit.
Might get
pushed
back.
They're like, Ken, guitars can't be flying around the ceiling, bro.
Exactly.
Well, thank you so much for your time, Ken, and inviting us into your studio here. And you guys, this has been an amazing experience. He even got me to do a quick mix here. It was so cool to do this on a 914 setup. And yes, the white speakers in the back are the Dutch and Dutch, the infamous. Aaron, I know you're jealous, buddy.
And they are godlike.
Yeah.
I mean, they sound phenomenal.
Love amazing, them. Amazing, amazing. And they have a price to match, too.
They do.
That's it from Datmos Studios. We'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.
Take care. Thanks.